Jeremiah 20, chapter 17. We all have to say amen. Jeremiah chapter 17. I want to talk to y'all about trusting in the Lord. Because there have been a lot of instances in 2009 where we walked outside of the will of God, not trusting everything that he said to us. And I think a lot of us are infected with the area of trying to do things ourselves rather than trusting God to do exactly what he said do, such that he brings forward everything in your life that's supposed to be inside of your life. That's why we have to trust him so we can be inhabited with the very thing he promised. So that's why when it talks about trust the Lord, that means to stay inside and stay in tune with the word and will of God such that your blessing is there when you should receive it. So in other words, my integrity of my waiting and trusting in God dictates to me rather how I receive the blessing, whether or not I receive the blessing. Is that clear? Am I making myself clear to you all? Okay, now I want to talk to you all about Jeremiah. Chapter 7, okay? And we want to, 17. We'll go in verse 5, okay? And we're going to read 17:5, we're going to go to 7, and then we're going to read to 13. I want to talk to you all about trusting in the Lord, who's your hope should be inside of them, okay? Yeah. I want to talk to y'all about it because, see, we have a problem with making flesh our own. Yeah. Whereas when you can't trust in God, how you relate to other people? Right. And prior to inside of those verses, it talks about how a person is cursed when they don't trust God, okay? And how you count on man and not God.
Yeah.
Sort of behooves you rather to trust God all the way in 2010, because I want to let you know that the same stuff that you had to deal with in 2009, you will not have to deal with it in 2010 if you declare.
If you declare, come on.
If you declare yourself not to go through the same stuff. See, our problem is not trusting man not trusting God all the way through when our tithes get off. Not trusting in God is a sin.
Yes.
Not trusting in God actually puts you in a state of bondage.
Yes.
Puts you in an area where you cannot make a righteous decision because all you see is your stuff.
Yes.
Stuff of what you're going through. Stuff of all the people who you count on.
Yes.
So look at it in this wise. The stuff that I dealt with in 2009, I won't deal with it this year because I have a God in 2010 that told me to lean on him. Trust on the inside of him. Not leaning to my own understanding, because why? He shall direct what? My path. Every step of the way, he kept my path. Every step of the way, he kept my path. Why? Because there's all my trust on the inside. As long as I trust him, he knows himself on the inside of my problem. So when I know him for myself,
yeah.
And I trust him all the way through my soul and my brain.
Yeah.
How are you gonna be with me?
Yeah.
All the way through. Now you know it's a messed up thing to have prophetic time.
Yeah.
And you mean to tell me you don't trust the same time? And then it talks about how after the trust, it said, and then it goes on to say, hey, Lord, if you heal me,
yeah.
I will be healed.
Yeah.
Now watch this.
Lord.
Isn't something how when you got your problems that you dealt with in 2009, how you been healed from them? And you carry those same problems. Jeremiah said, hey, if you heal me, I will be healed. Why? Because
my trust in you to do it. What is the use in saying that I believe God for everything else, but then when it comes down to my problems, I can't trust them through that stuff. I can't trust them for a car. I can't even trust them for a woman or a man. But how come we can't trust them when we got our back against the wall and our shoulders tied up and we can't go nowhere? We can't trust them through those dark areas when it seems like you all pop yourself. How come you can't trust them on the door? Your toes are talking and your time up is hurt. How can you not trust them when he's been right there? That's why he said, God, heal me. Heal me. Now shall we.